If we look at today's results, is the property market bucking the trend of the rest of the UK economy?
Well, today's results reflect what we're doing. You know, the economy is corrugated. The real estate market is flat. The real estate market produced 3.2% last year. We produce 7.8%. Why? Great developments, great operations.
But looking at valuations, it's all been driven by development. So is the rest of the portfolio struggling?
Well, you're right about the performance from our developments, and that's precisely why we have been developing over the last 3 years and will continue to do so. The window for us for development is open. As far as the remainder of our portfolio is concerned, it's performed broadly in line with the rest of the market, and this reflects the underlying economic conditions.
And so what happens if you don't let up those developments?
Well, we've made pretty good progress with our early schemes. So this year we completed 1.5 million square feet of space, which was 92% let or sold by the year end. And if you think about our markets, there isn't enough of the right type of space being built. And we have every confidence that we'll fill our schemes because we're building the right space in the right place at the right time.
Talk us through the results you're announcing today.
Well, the value of our properties increased by 2%, and that's worth £217.5 million. Our underlying profit, or revenue profit, came in at £290.7 million. That was down 2.9% on last year. Now, when you take those two together, they're the main factors behind our pre-tax profit, which was £533 million. That's up 3.4% on last year. If we turn to our adjusted net asset value per share, that was up 40p or 4.6% to 903 pence. And our dividend was increased by 2.8% to 29.8p.
And you say underlying profit is down, yet you say today's results are strong. So what's the story here?
Well, I think these are good results. We expected our revenue profit to decline due to sales we made last year, and also last year's numbers included some £10 million of non-recurring income. So these results are certainly in ahead of our expectations.
And both NAV and revenue profit are ahead of the market's expectations as well. So what did the market miss?
Well, on the asset valuation side, we saw a 16.8% increase from our developments, which helped drive outperformance versus our market index. And on revenue profit, we delivered good letting performance at our completed developments, and we also reduced our interest and administration costs.
And in terms of that operational performance, voids are down in both London and retail. So are market conditions easing?
Well, no, I wouldn't say that. Our letting team have worked very hard to protect income, letting up units, and we've preferred that over protecting rental values in our centres.
And turning to the balance sheet, your gearing reduced over the last year, but net debt increased. So are you where you want to be at this point in the cycle?
Yes, we are. Our aim has been to allow rising values to reduce our leverage, and that has occurred this year. Adjusted net debt is a little up on last year, but that's due to the balance of acquisitions and sales. Broadly, we aim to fund investment in acquisitions and developments from sales, but that's not going to happen perfectly each year. Last year, we sold more than we invested, and this year, we've done the reverse as we saw an opportunity to acquire some assets in the leisure sector.
But the debt markets are available to you. We've talked about this before, but shouldn't you be raising cheap finance when other people are struggling to finance their developments?
We have a very disciplined approach to investment. And there are no acquisition or development opportunities that we've missed out on through a lack of capital. What we are actually trying to do is to increase the amount of joint venture funding that we do from our group balance sheet where it's cheaper to raise debt.
And so what are your expectations for the year ahead?
Well, I don't think we're going to see significant rental growth in London or retail. So it's going to come down to our actions, just like this year. The speed at which we let up our developments and the timing of our disposals versus net investment, those are going to be the critical factors.
Turning to the London portfolio, 20 Fenchurch Street has let up well so far this year. Are you confident that this will continue?
Well, 20 Fenchurch Street has done well, yeah. We're 51% let by the year end, and we are confident that it's going to continue this way because the market is now beginning to realise that we're creating not only a great environment, but a highly efficient product. It's technically resilient and efficient space.
And so, is there any pressure on rents or incentives?
Well, markets are broadly flat, as I've said, and there isn't really much pressure on incentives. But if you look at our developments that we've completed in Leeds and Glasgow and 20 Fenchurch Street, for example, we're letting ahead of expectation.
And in Victoria, you've committed to your large development scheme in Victoria Circle. What gives you the confidence to start that now?
I think really that we're transforming the area. Victoria is being transformed into a great hub for people to work, live and play. And this is part of a program we've been working on right through the decade and will continue through to the end of this decade.
But you have no pre-lettings at the Zigzag building, and 62 Buckingham Gate is letting up slower than expected. So surely a degree of caution is required.
Yeah, don't forget that in the West End market, the market's not really predicated on pre-lettings. We finished 62 Buckingham Gate this week. We are 10% let at rents ahead of expectation, and we've got plenty of interest in the other floors. Zigzag building doesn't complete until January 2015. That's a year and a half away. And Victoria Circle, which we've committed to most recently, doesn't complete for another 16 months after that. We're redefining an area.
And what about your development plans at 1 and 2 New Ludgate and 1 New Street Square? Are they on the back burner for now?
These developments are absolutely not on the back burner. New Ludgate is fully designed and tendered and ready to go. Development, as we've always said, is about timing. We can produce a finished product within 23 months of pressing the start button. We expect to press that start button very soon, but we haven't pressed it yet. With 1 New Street Square, we only got planning consent last year. We only got vacant possession in December. We only agreed the deal with our freeholder in March. We've started demolition. We'll complete demolition at the end of this financial year, and we'll make the decision on when we start towards the end of this calendar year.
Are your residential plans reliant on a bubble?
No, I don't think we're in a bubble. Don't forget, we're building in prime central London, and all of our developments are located between Eaton Square and St James's Park. You know, this is an international city with an international audience, and there is a shortage of apartments.
Moving on to retail, once again, it's your development portfolio that's driven your performance. Your non-development retail portfolio has declined in value. So what can you do to turn this around?
Well, don't forget, retail is in a state of massive change, and it's tough for everybody. But we have actually outperformed the market with our non-development properties this year, which is good news. You're absolutely right about the developments performing well. We produced 2 shopping centres this year in Leeds and in Glasgow. They were more than 95% let or in solicitors' hands when they opened, so we completely nailed them. A great result by a great team.
And given the pressures on household incomes at the moment, surely your retail business will dilute your performance in London?
Well, London is performing very well at the moment, but don't forget it is a cyclical market.
And you've mentioned the 2 new shopping centres in Leeds and Glasgow, and they're delivering good returns, but what's next?
Well, as you will know, we're working on plans to develop the Westgate Centre in Oxford and also extend the Buchanan Galleries Centre in Glasgow. And in addition to that, we have quite a large programme of out-of-town or edge-of-town schemes, but mostly predicated on pre-lettings to retail winners.
During the year, you bought 2 leisure assets and extended your interest in ex-leisure. So remind us, what's the rationale here?
Well, as you know, retail is changing and consumer habits are changing very fast. People are going to shopping centres less often, but when they go, they spend longer there. So they expect to be fed and watered and expect to be entertained. So over the last few years, we've been building the proportion of leisure within our shopping centres, and we've extended that now to include it across the sector as a whole. So we have a very broad reach with the leading operators in the sector.
How do you extend the benefits of leisure to the rest of the retail portfolio?
Well, we already have for some time. So it really started with Cabot Circus in Bristol, where we developed a large number of food and beverage units within the development, and has concluded with Leeds this year, where 24% of the units are food and beverage.
And increasing your interest in ex-leisure in particular?
Well, let me take you back to last year. We originally bought 12% in ex-leisure as an opportunistic purchase because we saw some activity coming in the fund. So this year, we've taken advantage of that activity. We've built our stake in the fund, and it's given us access to a load of great assets at a great price.
And finally, outlook. What can we expect over the next 12 months?
Well, as we've said, our development window in London remains open, and we have a £1.2 billion programme committed to, so development lettings will be important. In retail, it's about providing the right space to our customers and connecting them to the consumers. And the economy remains uncertain, so it's going to be about the opportunities that we create. And as you can see from the results, we're pretty well placed.